whiskey on the rocks, please. Hello? Hey, nena. Solo estoy tomando un chocolate tratando de mojarme la polla. ¿Te contaré a mañana? Besos, puta. These assholes wondering, do I dare and do I dare? Alcohol. Liquid courage. Ha. Barkeep, a death in the afternoon, please. One part absinthe, one part champagne. What? You don't have that here? What kind of place is this? Who doesn't have absinthe?
I'm sorry, did you just order a death in the afternoon?
I don't stutter.
I've read it does wonders for seasickness. Are you about to cross the Atlantic on an ocean liner?
Is Columbus a coastal town? The only waves making me sick are those bar fries crashing before realizing I'd say, sure, you'll do. Barkeep!
Barkeep, a pass for the lady.
Did you just order PBR?
I thought we'd stick with this literary trend.
Come again?
Paps owned the rights to Falstaff's Brewing Company, which was named for
the biggest drunken fool in Shakespeare, yes, I am aware. But Falstaff has been out of taps for over a decade. What makes you think I even drink beer? I suppose that's fair. Let's keep it 20th century.
Okay, if we stick with Hemingway, we've got a couple options. We have a Cuba Libre, or perhaps a movie.
Whoa, let's move on to someone a little less obsessed with proving manliness. I've suffered enough of that today.
Jen Rickey.
Ooh, maybe someone who's not so goddamn smug. I mean, what kind of asshole believes you can't smell the gin on his breath despite his heavy and obvious drinking? Just because he managed to steal the heart of a Southern belle and her work. Well paired they might have been, but I have no idea who's able to put up with them.
Barkeep, two sidecars, please. Rum?
Oh. Drink again, the river that is the taker away of fame. Seems you're determined to get me between the sheets one way or another.
Well, if I'll do, I'll get you between the sheets, and I'll give you that little death in the afternoon all night. And as the light through yonder window breaks.
What did I say about Shakespeare? Besides, everybody already knows that in a package of minutes there is this week.
How beautiful.
Even at their basest, aspects of love always are.
Do I dare disturb how a minute keeps until further ones reverse their trade?
For I have known this all already, known it all. I've known the evenings, mornings, afternoons. I've measured out my life in absent spoons. I know the voice dying in a dying hall. Beneath the music from a farther room. So how should we presume? Sure, you'll do.